Hello my friends, I am Andreas Tzermiadianos, and today we will see some more examples for space, time and material. In the first game, we see Spassky with white, Lassen with black. The opening is a Karokan, e4, c6, d4, d5, knight c3, take, take, bishop e5, knight g3, bishop g6. Okay, now theory proposes this move as the most good one, although there are other ideas also. To my students, I propose to play this simple move. It is a good way if you don't want to know a lot of theory. The basic line goes like this: e6, castle, knight f6, c4, bishop d6 or e7, b3. Castle bishop b2, and white has a space advantage. Okay, they have one tempo more in the center. It is nothing special, but it's a very easy position to play with white. There is also the game Spassky-Karpov. White took on g6, h takes on g6, queen e2, rook e8, and knight e4, and white has some advantage. Okay, let's go back to our game. After bishop d3, Lassen is a well-known player for his imaginative play. He played queen a5 check. Now, we don't want to play c3, because in the setup we have to play c4 in one move. So, that's why Spassky played bishop d2. Now, of course, queen b6 is a little bit better, because it's not really threatening on b2, but it's a more active move. Lassen chose queen c7. Of course, now there is a threat of bishop take on d3, so white has to take on g6. Black took the h-pawn. Queen e2, a very good move to prepare long castle. Now, one of the basic minus of the double pawns is that the square in front of them can be a very good outpost. So, we see this in this position. If they play knight f6, knight g5 is a very strong move, and black cannot make long castle. After e6, white has some ideas, but not now. He can play castle, he can play rook e1, and threatening all the time here or here. When we think in all the colors, not only in 6 sacrifices, we can see also on f7 sacrifices. This is a very important concept. We don't think with one square, we think with all the square on the same color. So we have to think here, here and here what is going on. And also sometimes, if this is possible, not now but another position, can this be possible? Also here, you see, the concept is with all the white squares. Okay, let's go back. e6, knight e4. Now, if you play this, also the same problem. So he make long castle. Now, of course, he can make also long castle to allow e5, but it's very interesting move, g3. What is the purpose of this move? First of all, he can play bishop e4. Okay, so it's a very good idea in the Karokan when black made long castle. And also, he can have the f1, g2 in some queen a5 check after bishop f4. If he play e5, he opened the position. We have the better development. Okay, we see we have two pieces more. He has this and this. So, our development is good. And he opened the position. It's better for white. That's why he plays c5. The idea of c5 is that white, of course, cannot play, because black can take. Even with a bishop or with a knight, it's okay. And after bishop f4, I think check is a better idea. Okay, Lassen played queen c6. So, queen c6, long castle. White has a lot of ideas. You see, the rook can transfer to d3. So, after the extension c3, to play on c5 to go to c3. The black king has some problems, because of the bishop on f4, and also black cannot develop easy his pieces because after Nf6, Ng5 is coming all the time. So the real idea of Larsen was to play c4 in this position. And this is a position I want to analyze. In this position, we see that black has the space, of course. He has 3 and 1, 4 and 1, 5. Okay? White has 2 and 1, 3. So the space generally is with black. This is obvious now. What white has? White has a lot of time. Not only time, a lot of time. Because there is 2 pieces and white is playing. So the material, okay, we see that black has some double pawns. This c4 is a little bit weak, but the rooks are quite okay, the queen is quite okay, so white has only the time. So the problem is how to open the position. If we think in this term, we will find the move. If we don't think in this term, we will never find a move. We have to be a grandmaster or an international master to find a move. It is not easy. So the only thing we have to do now is how to open the position. So this is the idea. Spassky played a very simple move, knight c3. It seems that black has a lot of ways to stop the d5 push, but no one is sufficient because whatever he play, he let something. So if he played rook h5 to protect the d5, there comes also this, but I prefer this, knight g5. Now he threat this, and this is a threat also. If he try to protect the d5 with knight f6, now, as we know, we have knight g5. If he try to protect with knight b6, the knight was protecting the d5 square. Now we have this move. So it's not easy to protect it. Larsen played knight a6, and now d5. He took, how will take on d5? It's very important to bring all the pieces in the game. So we take with the rook. This is a very good idea because we want to bring the other rook and also the rook to protect this important square. Because after knight came, if knight came here, the game is over. There is a threat on a7. The queen cannot go out because c4 also is hanging, you see. So he play bishop c5, rook here, and now f6. If he play here, and you see how we continue, this is a very strong move. Now he cannot take with the queen because it's mate, and if he take with the queen, then we take, he take the queen, we have check, check, and wins the rook. Okay, so let's go back. Black play f6. The idea is to protect the e5 and the g5 square, to have some ideas with g5, and also to play knight f7. And this is the most critical position in the game, because what we want to do is not so easy. If we play what, knight d4, he just take and play knight b6. The important thing to understand here is this bishop. This bishop kicks everything. Keeps this square, keeps this square. He protects all the critical squares. So I want to take this bishop and bring a knight here to win the game. But how to do this? Of course, rook takes c4 is nothing. Rook takes c5 is nothing. Queen takes c4 is a mistake because there is check. Stay focused all the game. We can easily lose like this if we are not concentrated. So the good move is rook d6. I take without opening the d-line. It's very important. Because now black has to protect the c4. So after here, queen c5, rook d5, black resigns. Because knight c6 comes knight b5. You cannot protect everything. And this is hanging. If you play queen b6, queen takes c4. This was the first game. A very good game from Spassky, but the knight c3, it's easy to find if you use the space, time and material method. In the second game, I'm black with Grandmaster Inkyov. It was from an open in Heraklion 1993. We play the Bengo Gambit. It was one of my favorite openings in the pre-computer area. Okay, let's move. E45. It's very important when you play with a better player to try to have some, not too many pawns break in the center. Not to allow the opponent to have many pawn breaks, because it is more easy for him, that he has more experience, he's a better player, to make problems for you. If the center is stable, it's not so difficult to handle the position. G3, G6, H4, improve the bishop, exchange the bishop, and okay, lose the castle, it's not important this position. So, back, queen G4, bishop H6, and now he give a pawn. Let's see this position. First of all, white has 2 and 1, 3, into 5, into 7, 3, 10, 12, too much. Let's see black. 1 and 2, 3, and 4, and 2, 6, and 3, 9. 12, 9. Of course, the space is with white. But it's very easy to see this because he has these 3 pawns, this d5 gains a lot of space for him. So, the space is with white. Okay. But, time. Not so important. Maybe I have one tempo more, but it's not so important because the position is closed. Okay, the position has to be open, so time to count for something. And the pieces, I cannot say that this is a bad bishop on h6, because it will be exchanged or it will be better than the bishop c1. So, after all, white has something small, the space. It's not good to give this pawn. What is the meaning of giving this pawn? Of course, I took the pawn immediately. He has some ideas because the queen has not many squares, but okay, I play knight h5. Threat the queen, go back, king e2, knight d7, and a5. Okay, this is a very nice move because he opened also this diagonal for the queen to come g6, queen e7, queen a4, castle, and bishop h6. Okay. Now we have a position to analyze. White has some time now, because his pieces are quickly moving around my king. He has to play this, he has ideas of this. We have to understand what is black with black side. What black has in this position. In this position, the problem is only the white king, nothing more. Okay, we have also one pawn material. And now I play a good move. And Van Veli, who's playing also in this tournament, and after the tournament he liked this game, as he said to me, I play a5. This is a very logical move. You cannot allow to lose time now. He has to take the rook. Let's see the position now. The position has changed now, because the king is in the middle. The position will be open. E-file, I don't know, but it will open. I have one pawn, and also the position is closed, so the rook is not better than a knight in this position. He has to open a file, so his rooks to go inside the black's position, and this is not possible, because he has only the h-file. So, he moved the queen back, and now we take on e4. He took knight f6, and queen e3. Think how you will continue in this position. The only logical move is e4, because we need to evacuate this square so the queen can come. You will have some threats. Knight e2 and queen e5. Rook h1. Also, I don't understand. There is no reason to give this b2, but also he has to be careful and to play what? If he play b3, the rook is hanging. If he play rook b1, it's not easy to have a plan. Also, think that I can have this idea sometimes. This is also a good outpost for a knight. So he play rook h1. I took the pawn. A very good advice from my friend GM Yannis Papayoannou. When you make an attack, take the material. In the way to the attack, take some material. If it doesn't change the character of the position, if it doesn't stop your attack, take some material because it's very important also to have something as you will go in the end game. So now we have no material less. We have knight and two pawns for a rook. He played g4 and knight go back. Rook h3, queen to e5. Black now has a very good position. All his pieces are protecting the king. The b pawn is very good for the end game. He play queen g3. Okay, now it comes in the time pressure also. Of course, we don't exchange queens because his king is weaker than our king. Okay? Very many times I see this mistake to exchange queen because I have the material. When I have an advantage, I don't give any of this advantage. Okay. Queen h2. He wants to make an attack. And now black is in, white is in very bad shape because he has 9, 5, and 5. So 19 points doing nothing there. After h5, they are doing nothing. He played g5. Okay. I have to go back. Took the pawn and also took the pawn. Now it's very bad for white because the knight is coming to d4, the knight is coming to f6 or to g4, and also during the game, think if you have pieces. One moment to erase this. So see if you have bishops in this. This is the peripheral avenue for me. This I say to my students. If you have many points there, something is going wrong. From all his points that white has now, he has in the h-file 9 and 5, 14. More than half his pieces are in the peripheral zone. So this is very bad. He play rook g3. And the pieces are coming now. You see, the passed pawn create a very good outpost also. He give the exchange, but it's difficult to have something and check. You see, I don't exchange queen, take on f4. And of course, that here he resigns. I don't exchange because I win a piece on e4. On king f3, comes queen d3. But generally, don't exchange queens. You have the advantage. Because you have the advantage. Keep the advantage as big as possible. Okay, when you have a small advantage, after some moves, you have to, you need to have a bigger advantage, not the same. If you are slightly better in the move 12, and slightly better in the move 40, you make something wrong. So, this for now, we'll see some more videos later. Thank you.